Right, so this next opening is probably going to be the most left field one, right? Yeah, Bakugan. Childhood, blast from the past, right? So I went and grabbed around 80 bucks Oz of Bakugan to open. Now, hear me out, right? I wouldn't be doing this if I didn't think there was a valid talking point or comparison to make between this and what? Equivalents should be about 16 packs. So we'll grab four, 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 and you guessed it, four more. Right. So that's the Bakugan equivalent to Dusteldon. Right. So we'll open these and those. And yeah, we'll have some discussion. I'm going to start with the tin. Right. I'm actually very intrigued open this because it was amazing when it first came out, right? Everyone had to have it's the fact that you had cards and essentially marbles that then popped out and transformed into D&D. We'll go with those comparisons. Was mind blowing as a child, right? So yeah, I'm pretty sure it still does well, right? Still sure there's a lot of people interested. I saw that the product was like the season being season 15. All I remember was the big plot twist. In the original anime, where Mysterion? No, it wasn't. The name wasn't. Oh, Masquerade, right? Was the chick that was mind blowing. But yeah, what is the big talking point? Well, that's cool. You got little holes for the Bakugan. Wow. What could Flesh and Blood kind of do with this stuff underneath? Oh, there's trays. I was not expecting it. I was just honestly expecting a tin. And then we have the metallic cards. So these are so you can actually store them. That's actually really cool, right? Because then you put that on top, you've got these little cards that go in there, and then these keep all your things nice and safe. This head all popped out. These actually all popped out. But yeah, action figures, right? I think a lot of us draw the conclusion that Flesh and Blood is they metallic? No, I remember these cards being metallic. They feel metallic. It's your little bottom thing. Anyway, a lot of us draw the conclusion that Flesh and Blood is kind of like Dungeons and Dragons, right? It's very RPG-ish. You assemble your hero, you equip them, and you have your abilities as your deck rather than, a sheet of paper. So, action figures could really serve a purpose in the product design of Flesh and Blood. And in line with that, right, when we think of these extra stuff, how do I put your feet back? How do I close you? I remember them just being spring action. Okay, you can stay there for now. But yeah, action figures for Flesh and Blood, right? Models for your deck. Models of all the core heroes, and you have them out. All right, you could have their little base stand or something be the life counter. Right, with dials. I know there are some fantastic pieces of fan-made tokens, counters, all that would be great. I don't want to see dice. I don't want to see spin down dice. Right, I think they could get really creative with it, especially because again, your hero is gonna stick with you for quite a while. So to have an action figure of Reyna, an action figure of Dorinthia, stuff like that can work more so than any other game, like MTG, a model of Jace doesn't really work because you're not really playing as Jace. You get the support of Jace if you play him, and you might not really run him in every deck. But every warrior deck is either going to be Bolton or Dorinthia when it comes to what's constructed. So to have your life counter, this is probably pretty loud, right? Me fiddling with the tin. To have your life counter as this little action figure would be great. Right, you can just stick it on the table, twirl the little numbers, have your little figure, and it's just something that I'm sure a lot of people would actually consider and buy. I find it curious that these are like round shaped, but they go like that, and then a third one can't really fit there. I don't recall what these are. These little tokens. I remember you play the cards, and you roll your fucking gun onto it. If you miss, you fail, the marbles aspect. Someone explain to me the current ins and outs of Bakugan. Come on. But yeah, to could definitely work. And you could take it a step further, right? You could have armor, equipable sets of armor, depending on the scale or the model that you use, right? You could go all in with like Warhammer and just have them as viable, you know, different poses or stuff like that. Maybe stock standard armor sets, depending on, you know, what set version they're from. Granted, we never see a lot of change in the art, right? So, for instance, Levia being reprinted in Dusseldorn is still the stock standard Levia. Now, we didn't see any update, aside from the main card, the Marvel card, right, of her, you know, waging war or growing as an individual when it comes to the sets and the lore. But you could do that. You could do that with the action figures. You could have Levia, you know, post her transition to this corrupted entity, and then you could have her fully acclimatized and stuff like that. What is this? Oh, it's a normal wire that's been tied. I don't think I have scissors. Knife. Sorry, these really intrigue me. I love Marvel growing up. It's like the first thing we could convince our teacher to let us play indoors. It taught hand-eye coordination, right? Counting and addition. Then we took it with Pokemon, same thing, counting, whatnot. And we tried with Yu-Gi-Oh, and that is where we lost them. Because Yu-Gi-Oh was a bit just weird, you know? At least Pokemon, you've got they look like just creatures. Especially the initial set, they just look like, you know, a mouse. Pikachu standard. But yeah, what do you think? Do you think merchandise could actually work for Dusseldorn? Like, you could have Harry Potter. Okay, this is very a weird video, but bear with me. Right, Harry Potter, the first one that came out, you had the dolls, I should say action figures, for the chess pieces, right? So the chess pieces, I had the knight, okay? He squeezes his legs, he explodes, and his armor goes everywhere, okay? Wouldn't that be cool as Flesh and Blood, right? You have Dorinthia, you've got, like, little pegs or slots on them, so you can equip the armor that you're actually using, right? They could come out with models of all the equipment for you to buy, right? Give your money directly to Legendary Studios. Again, big thing that I will continue to state needs to be done. And yeah, you can have them equipped to your little action figure of Dorinthia, right? All you need is some pegs on the back, some slots, and I guess size-wise would be the only complication, because you would have Reiner be, you know, maybe bigger, and equipment would be weird. But you could standardize all of them, right? It wouldn't be too hard to do that. And yeah, I think it would sell. I think a lot of us are, you know, RPG nerds at heart, and would definitely buy into action figures, to models, to all these things, for Flesh and Blood, even just landscaping. Or I know they have their partnership. Oh, this is not a circle. Since when are they not circles? This one, at least I figure out how to close for the head. The head's meant to be in. Still pop open? Where's the... Oh, it's there. Ah, you roll it like a cylinder. Interesting. But yeah. It needs to be done. Right, again, in the MTG, we talked about expanding into different packs, right? Different assets that they can sell to people, again, to try and gain a larger portion of the financial spending for themselves, right, outside of the secondary market. That was very loud. Action figures. If they don't want to step on the toes of the secondary market, they don't want to, you know, impede on the collectability or meddle with anything like that, or they go through all the hassles of printing anything, right? Models would work perfectly. I'm not going through cards. Are the cards collectible? Right. We'll open some Dusseldorn. We've got one left, but we'll open Dusseldorn. We'll put you guys aside there, so we've got a little bit of room. How creative were these? In all honesty, right? You roll them, they pop open, and you got your little action figure. Right, obviously, we don't want Flesh and Blood Bakugan, right? They pop open into Dorinthia. Right, that could be cool, right? Don't have them stab or something like that, use an attack. But I do think, you know, alternative merchandise could work. Okay, leave deck boxes, leave sleeves, all that, to... Ooh, Cold Foil. It's just a rare. To me, it's a common, right? It's not a great card. Not a great set of equipment. But yeah, there is lots of alternatives, and again, it's about pulling information, pulling ideas from other people. You can still respect your collectability, you can still respect that, and you can do things tastefully, as opposed to, again, I will use the example of MetaZoo, because we all kind of think that it's kind of gone overboard, right? With the amount of merchandising that Mike has done. Again, he knows his audience, he knows how to market his trademark, right? But, again, Flesh and Blood can easily figure out what its demographic wants, and again, I would be highly amiss if it wasn't models, right? A little Dorinthia action figure that you can equip a spring tunic to, all these different gauntlets, and you know, you could have them in metallic, shiny, right? The equipment, I mean, so it's as though they're wearing the cold foil equipment. There's lots of ways that it can be done, and all it takes is some creative thought and looking at the competition, essentially, right? How can you encapsulate on what these other design... How can you encapsulate what these other companies are doing in terms of their design and use it for yourself, right? It's not theft if you do it correctly, if you do it tastefully, if you do it with your own identity. I mean, tins, boxes, all that. There is so much that they could do, and I don't know if it's their ideology. They don't want to compromise, right? They want to very much stick to the roots of MTG, just collecting and opening. But the big concern I think everyone has, right, when James White is done, right, when he hands over the company, be it, you know, rest in peace, or he steps down and he gives it to someone, what happens then, right? Do the ideologies really just change? Do we get a whole new Flesh and Blood that a lot of us are not going to be happy with? But the easiest thing to do, if you were him, right, you need to understand that change is necessary. You need to understand that, again, a company that doesn't grow is a worthless company, right? It doesn't matter if you are making money, if you stay still, if your revenue is the same as last year, right? For all intents and purposes, from anyone looking at you as a business, as a company, you are failing, okay? So to understand that and lay the groundwork for it to be done, if it needs to be done, right, in the manner that you would find acceptable, okay? And again, I do think Warhammer-style figures would be fantastic for for Flesh and Blood in its entirety. There's not that many to really make, right? We've got, if you just do Classic Constructor, you just target the core heroes. Again, you could then tie it back into the products we're talking about, right? You could get the boxes, the VIP boxes, whatever you want to call them. Again, someone give me a good name. And you could have that have, you know, a little Dorinthia figure, a core set of cards for Dorinthia, and then again, those chase cards to actually make it viable as a reoccurring product. Or, again, you could just go into supporting the back end, right? Just set up a division of Legendary Studios for this manufacturing of merchandise, right? Playmats do terrific. I don't see why action figures or little models or even just proper die-cast life counters wouldn't be fantastic, right? There are a lot of people out there who have come up with this stuff. There is some fantastic ones that I've seen, again, for tokens, for proper solid and metallic tokens rather than the token cards, that would fit beautifully into products. And the easiest thing to do as a small company, as someone who is really invested in the passion, is to go to these people, right? Recruit. It would be their dream to turn that style of manufacturing from a hobby into something with the full support of Legend of Story Studios, of James White, right? I mean, take the artist serialized cards from Dust Till Dawn. Also, I still have not seen one Angel. I've opened, I want to say, 3-4 cases at this point, and I have not gotten one Archangel. But yeah, you could make so many people happy, and you could take a lot of the work off you if you outsource it to these people who are enjoyable. You just back them with the infrastructure, with the connections to actually produce these high-end things. And I personally think it would really excel in Flesh and Blood, right? Would you, in all honesty, would you be happy having these models, having, you know, other alternative forms of supporting Legend of Story Studios, of these little things that you can really show off as your love, right? Iron Song Versus? I was going to say Venus. That's a creative name. Also called for Legendary. I know. I'd be excited. it's hard when you're following a train of thought, right? Because what I really want to address with this, right? So again, you have the little Dorinthia, you know, and you have these gauntlets that you can now equip, right? They're metallic. All she has is like a little peg on her arm, so you can slot it on and you can take it off once it's broken. You know, I think people would get enjoyment out of it. Obviously, when it comes to competitive, you'd run into the issues of timing and not doing that. But as a novelty sense, as people just playing in a casual sense, or even at LGS, at the small-scale competitive events, I think lots of people would love and get enjoyment out of that style of product, right? Having your embodiment of Dorinthia, having something you could essentially paint yourself or customize, right? Instead of alt art cards, you'd have these alt art figures where, you know, you've changed Dorinthia's hair, you've customized the face a little bit or something like that to make it more in line with what you envision as you being a Dorinthia player. And then again, have all the equipments be purchasable and be able to attach on using some sort of peg system onto these little models. And I think it'd be fantastic. I think it is a solid thought to have for Legend of Destroy Studios in terms of expanding. Right, you don't want to listen to my complaints or arguments about expanding supplemental sets or core sets or focusing on X heroes. It's fine. There are wonderful alternatives, and you don't have to go down the rabbit hole of t-shirts and all this other merchandise, what, keychains and stuff like that. You can do tasteful products. Oh, this one is transparent. You can do tasteful products that a lot of people will enjoy. We should probably look at the card a little bit. Also, hands down, another victory to Flesh and Blood, I would say, right? So we got the Diadem Extended Art Concord versus the, what was it? Blightsteel Colossus from the VIP box. So that was definitely a win for Flesh and Blood. Now we get the Iron Sun Venus versus these, which I don't know if they have collectible value. Do they have collectible value? I assume in the old one too. It's another one of those things where you wish you didn't, you know, throw out. But hey, what can you do? I'm very curious. Oh, he's got a little pull tag, which means he has a battery in him, which means he probably lights up. Interesting. Too bad he's like the weird centipede guy. You remember some of them. Yeah, he does light up. I don't know how to make him light up, though. Button? No? We'll try folding him up. Yeah, let me know your thoughts, your feelings. These are really hard to close compared to what I remember. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes. They flip. Right, how could you do this one-handed? Right? You could not close this one hand. One hand. Oh. Oh. Okay, there we go. I'm guessing, yeah, when he pops, he lights up. Still. Right? I just wanted to experience my childhood again. Fantastic. Again, you know, a little Iron Song card, weird little Iron Song gauntlets that you can equip to your model, and life counters. I think that would be my perfect embodiment of this idea, right? Have a little figurine, you know, I don't know sizes, I'm not going to say inches because of metric, right? I'm Aussie. So you have a little figurine on the little base plates, right? You have your little life counter with it, just a spin dial that you can turn, right? Goes up to 40, goes up to 20, and then on the actual Dorinthia, continue with this example, right? You can get all this equipment to put and peg on to your hero to show them actually wearing the gear and the setup you're using, right? It'll be wonderful customization, and again, the personal touch for any player to actually, you know, embody the hero that they're playing. Very interesting. Bunch of numbers, less text than what I remember. It's more the figurines that we like, right? A little ball dragon. Little hands. He's got pegs on them. Do they not come out? Curious. Anyway, we'll leave it there. Tell me, what do you think? Decent idea? Worth consideration? Hope you enjoyed. See ya.